you'll get paid out as a winner. So take the A-League to the Neds level. Head to the Neds app or neds.com.au for all your latest markets, and always remember to gamble responsibly.
Take it to the Neds level.
Know when to stop. Don't go over the top. Gamble responsibly.
Thanks, Tara. Yes, I've got a couple of the Georgians on both sides of the equation today. And these two, Becca Mikhail-Tadze from Newcastle and Bichana Arabuli from Macarthur, they both actually played together in Georgia about 6 years ago for Dinamo Tbilisi. Now, they haven't come up against each other since they played together. Becca, what are your memories of that time?
Yeah, it's good memory. Me and Bacho played together. It was nice. Many, many good memories. But in this time, yeah, I say Bacho playing in striker and I play winger. And yeah, it was nice because I give many, many assists Bacho, and Bacho score, I run because of Bacho. And yeah, it was nice.
So Bacho, plenty of great balls that Becca played to you. So you're playing in the middle. Which side was Becca playing on?
Becca was on right wing. Yeah. Yeah, I was a striker. We play same system, like 4-2-3-1. Yeah, coach just decided to move Becca on the right side. I think just one season he was playing on the wing. He's, you know, his life striker, but yeah, we had a good good team up in the attack.
And you both come to Australia. Bacho, of course, this is your first season. Becca, you spent last season here. And you, just yesterday, you both celebrated your Orthodox Christmases. Now, I asked you before how it was. You didn't seem that excited because you couldn't eat that much. Is that fair to say, Bacho?
Yeah, of course, as much as we can to have celebrate Christmas before the game there, because it's such an important game for both team, I think. And yeah, we had this just a calm, relaxed Christmas, just celebrate and didn't eat so much, of course.
And Becca, of course, key match today as well for the Jets, looking to bounce back after the Sydney defeat.
Yeah, not only today, it's every match, it's important, you know. And yeah, we wish today we take 3 points today, but it's not my friend, only today.
Boys, thank you so much for having a chat to us here on Network 10 and Paramount Plus.
Thank you so much.
So history awaits one way or another. And he bends it. What a goal. He's done it again. Remember the name.
This is just pure touch, instinct, confidence.
Western United have won the A-League Championship. Well, two teams who got a bit of a reality check last week. MacArthur returned to the scene of the greatest triumph in their short history, the Australia Cup final, and had their pants pulled down by Western Sydney Wanderers. The Newcastle Jets caught Sydney FC on a good day and came away scoreless and pointless. All of which makes today's encounter in Campbelltown important for both as they seek a return to the top six. It is a gloriously sunny afternoon in the southwest of Sydney as the teams get ready, as you can see, on our Isuzu Ute tunnel cam. The last time they met at the back end of last season, the Jets made off from here with a 3-0 success, but that remains their only win in the five meetings between the pair. And scoring goals this season remains a problem for Arthur Pappas's team, with just one in their last four matches. The Bulls are a little more free scoring, helped by the integration of Bachana Arabuli into the team. So it was last week just a bad night at the office for MacArthur, or something a little more sinister? We're about to find out. Here's the team news. MacArthur are unchanged from the side that got belted by the Wanderers last week. The 11 getting a shot at redemption, perhaps in part due to the ongoing injury to Daniel De Silva, who misses out once again due to that injury sustained against Sydney FC. Al-Hassan Toure and Craig Noon continue to keep Daniel Arzani on the bench. Matthew Miller and Ivan Vujica line up against their former club. Striker Bachana Arabuli, one of three Georgians involved today. He's a former teammate of the Jets' Vekha Mikulcadze, and he turned 29 on Thursday. A couple of changes for the Jets. Carl Jenkinson pays the price for defensive lapses last week as he's benched, with James McGarry returning at left back and Dane Ingham reverting to the right. The other change is in midfield, where Callum Timmins makes his first start for the club alongside Angus Thurgate. Becca Dartsmulia drops down to the bench. Matt Yerman and Brandon O'Neill, who sustained a calf injury in training yesterday, are not part of the matchday squad. And that means, along with Jenkinson, none of the club's three co-captains are in the starting 11 today. Well, as you can see, conditions rather warm today. There is Dwight York, who scored just his second A-League goal for Sydney against the Newcastle Jets back in 2005. Just a consolation, though, in a 2-1 loss at the then Energy Australia Stadium. As for Arthur Pappas, his team have won two of their last three away games, but overall they've lost six of their last eight. He could really do with a victory today. Our referee this afternoon is Adam Kersey, his 74th match in the middle, and he was in charge of that last meeting between the pair at this venue in May of last year. Well, Reno Piscopo is one of the players that the Jets will be looking towards to provide a little bit of creative spark. Still playing with that strapping on his right wrist and thumb. And there's Bachana Arabuli, who's been involved in four of the last five goals for MacArthur, scoring three of them, which makes him the club's top goal scorer. Quick readjustment of the laces for Ulysses Davila, the MacArthur skipper. Always a joy watching him play, as we do this man, Vekha Mikulcadze. He is joint top scorer with Trent Bahadur with two this season. And Bahadur, another one not involved in the matchday squad for the Jets today. So the final game of round 11, an all New South Wales affair, and one that has significant bearing on the fringes of the finals race, with just 3 points separating Adelaide in fourth from the Jets in ninth. And a fast-paced start as well, Andy Harper.
Good afternoon, Simon. Brilliant conditions for summer football here in Campbelltown. Both teams stung with subpar performances last week. A lot of turnover in the Newcastle team. Dwight York, the boss of MacArthur, has kept the same 11 with a stay of execution. Up to the players to respond, and the evidence from the starting whistle is that they'd heard the message loud and clear. Long way to go, needless to say. Can they keep it up against a team who is battered and bruised? Horrible goal-scoring record, Newcastle this year. And a very talented MacArthur team. It's not yet the sum of its parts. It was showing, as you quite rightly said, Simon, a lot of promise in the run to lift the cup, Australia Cup, but it's just faltered somewhat. Doesn't take away from the quality of the individuals at home. They should do too much for Newcastle, you'd expect.
James McGarry leaning over the top of Craig Noon. That's one battle to keep an eye on today. McGarry, who missed out against Sydney. He's going a little too strong on Noon. Former Wellington Phoenix player, who were involved in all that drama, of course, yesterday at the Sydney Football Stadium. So we have a quieter afternoon in that regard today. Off the head of Dane Ingham. And out off Charles Mombwa. Continuing in midfield with Daniel De Silva still absent. Oh, Vuitz has got in a bit of a mess there. Jets unable to profit through Josh Sotirio. Who is their solitary goal scorer in the last four matches. Important one it was as well. The winner in Adelaide. There was a slight bit of contact. It was a rather theatrical fall, but Adam Kersey has awarded the free kick. Newcastle have scored just one set-piece goal so far this season. That came from a corner. Let's see if they can improve upon that. Spin up in the air. And Arabuli, strong in the challenge. Too strong for Piscopo. Craig Noon has been reeled in. Piscopo trying to square it up for Thurgate. It's a good intervention by Charles Mombwa. Again, the fast-paced nature of these early stages continues unabated. Moon bumped off the ball by Thurgate, who threads it through beautifully. And away goes Sotirio, gets the first shot on target. And it's no real problem for Philip Curtin.
Unfortunately for Newcastle, no. Nice work from Renato Piscopo putting Sotirio through. His run was good, his touch was poor. And it took him way too wide of the target. Jonathan Aspro-Potamidis, the number five for MacArthur, was struggling to make up the distance defensively. Sotirio has got good pace, but it was a really substandard first touch, and the pressure off for MacArthur.
Timmins with Jake Holman snapping at his heels, committing the foul. Jake Holman was excellent against Sydney a couple of games back, really controlled the midfield, but in common with many of his teammates, just could not back it up against the Wanderers. They were so subpar. Maybe the fact that Dwight York's gone with an unchanged 11 indicates that he feels it's just a bit of a blip. They had a bad night at the office. That's to take nothing away from the Wanderers, who were excellent that night. Foul by Mombwa.
Yeah, big win. Fabulous win for the Wanderers last week, but unfortunately for them and their fans, they couldn't back it up this weekend. Very strong performance from the Glory at home. A run of home games for Perth. Maybe they'll start to climb a couple of notches on the table, but it has been the theme of the competition. Very difficult for everyone else, it seems, apart from Melbourne City. to get a run of momentum going.
Well, the Mariners are closest to Melbourne City at the moment, 6 points adrift. Dwight York's team can return to the top six with a win today. In fact, they'll go fourth if they get the 3 points. Jets will sneak into the top six if they can get the chocolates. They've got a free kick, but they can't take it from there. Nor there. I'm still not sure who's in the right spot when they went for it a third time. Natter. And with Callum Timmins. He's had to wait a while for his starting debut. Heavy off the chest of Arabuli. Piscopo. Little interchange with Thurgate. Strong challenge. But a fair one by Hushcock. And MacArthur will spring forward. It's Craig Noon on the right. A little threaded ball through is the right idea, but Davila couldn't get on the end of it. Well, Jordan Elsie is leading the protest. He feels the Jets should have had a free kick.
Yeah, I disagree with Jordan. I completely understand why he's making the call. But some good football from both teams. Gliding across the ground nicely was Piscopo. My first reading, this is a fair challenge from Hushcock, and he gets his toe in there to win the ball. He might have got a little bit of Renault's back as well. We hope he's okay. He started quite brightly. There's no free kick in that, in my view. I agree with the ref. Great defending from Hushcock. And a nice ball forward, and MacArthur then had a good shot at worrying Jack Duncan in Newcastle's goal.
Skippo just having the small of the back stretched out, which is where the contact was made. And he is the most fouled player in the competition. I guess that's sort of what you expect when you're a player like him. Tries to get in those little pockets between the lines. Diminutive stature, great touch on the ball. Miller, lovely feet, great shimmy too to get rid of the defender. That would have been an excellent goal. And there's a clash of heads here, I fancy.
Unlike the source, Davila standing in through the 6 yard box, beautiful feet there from Matt Miller, and a ball right into the danger zone, and Davila steaming in. Jordan Nelson's to his feet, which is good to see. A sharp work down the right from Matt Miller.
I think he just got a glancing blow to the schnoz there, Jordan Nelson, which can make the eyes water. A brisk start from both sides. Now the clapping in the stands is for the passing of 12-year-old Liam Cantarella, who was a junior player with the Camden Tigers, who tragically passed away this week. So all at MacArthur Bulls paying their respects, and the players wearing black armbands as well. Our thoughts and sympathies to Liam's family and friends. Davila gave up the chase quite early on that one.
Yeah, not quite the touch on that delivery from Matt Miller as there wasn't the cross for the same target. Davila will lead the way. Matt Miller has swapped the black and white of St Mirren for the black and white of MacArthur. And there's a very powerful presence down that right-hand side. Just got to find his range on that passing. The first effort was a really good one. The second, not so good.
Incidentally, just on St Mirren, they drew overnight, and their goal had a real Aussie flavour to it. Keanu Backus fouled in the box by Cammy Devlin, and the spot kick converted by Ryan Strain. Talking of Backus's, there's Kieran, Keanu's brother, on the bench with the towel, just shielding him a little bit from the sun. has been displaced in the starting 11 by a man who just headed the ball there, Jake Holman. Slung forward by Natter. Curto out to play sweeper keeper. Nodded out by Ushko. Gowie looking for movement. Really get it. A straight swap, James McGarry coming to Newcastle and Lucas Moragas going the other way to Wellington. On loan, the latter deal. Underneath it was Timmins. Elsie got a piece of it. Graveler went to ground, but no foul given. Craig Noon in possession. Gavala back up and about. Holman. Mombwa. Nice little pirouette to take him away from trouble in the first instance. Noon. Norris Miller, who was is outside, up in the air by Natter. Is impeded by Gavala. Sotirio. Rosos. Wide right is Thurgate. All the passing lanes were blocked for Costa Grosos. For the Jets, put it behind Dane Ingham. Quite on the same page. Touré couldn't control it. Here's Becca Mikkeltatsa for the Jets. Thurgate. Corner ball off Jonathan Aspro, bottom meters.
The set piece has generally not been great for Newcastle this year, although it was from this side of the field. Their last goal came, not on this particular stadium, against the Mariners. Mikkeltatsa to the back post with a header to seal the point. That's their only goal in the four games preceding this one.
And this corner to be taken in front of the travelling Jet supporters by Grosos. Elsie got underneath it and got it on target, and gathered by Curto. Release just a fraction too sharp for Davila from the ball's goalkeeper. And the Jets are back on the attack through Ingham. That's by Potamitis again. Positioned in the right spot. Quickly taken throw. Thurgate trying to wrap his boot around it. It's going to be another corner. That's by Potamitis. Got a whack to the shin, I think, from Thurgate on the way through, which clearly hurt.
But not so much that he didn't have the mind, presence of mind to roll himself, WWE-like, back into the canvas. It's the follow-through that gets Jonathan. There he is, off the field. And just to make sure that the ref can't get things going without him, very cannily, with a couple of rolls, makes himself pitch-worthy again.
Always thinking. In comes the corner. Natter leaping for it. Maybe lost it in the sun. Arthur looking to sprint forward, but it's going to get away from Touré.
A bit sloppy there. Sloppy from the Jets, and then sloppy in transition from MacArthur. Davila, of all people, missing that pass for Touré. He could have been able to retrieve that ball. It would have been a contest worth watching thereafter. Hassan Touré, rather, versus Dane Ingham and Ken Mota. Would have been worth the watch.
Josh Sotirio is pretty good quick across the ground as well. Squares it up, and Grosos is intended ball for Mikkel Tanzer. I fancy took a touch off a defender. Holman. Robbed on the blind side. Good scrapping by the Jets. Timmins. Thread it through for Renault Piscopo.
And I like the way the Jets have set up to start this game. 15 inside. Piscopo listed as a left winger, but he's playing as a left-sided number 10. Thurgate as a right-sided number 10, which I think is a great position for Angus. Towards Mikkel Tadze and Soterio as two strikers going through the middle. And I quite like the adjustment that Pappas has brought on that basis for this game.
Blooded into the challenge with Holman. Determined to make the most of his maiden Jet start, the former Perth Glory midfielder. Throw by Gary as reach Soterio. Piscopo. Intervention. James McGarry clearly thinking about the long throw. It's like a 10-pin bowler. The wind just holds it up. Mikkel Tadze helped it on. Chested down by Thurgate. And across the face of goal after hitting the post off the boot of Renault Piscopo. And the Jets were oh so close.
Very close. And there would have been a real point of contention. Simon, I don't know if you noticed, but when McGarry takes that throw in, he's clearly overstepped the sideline in launching the ball.
How often do we see that gets penalised, though?
Well, in these days of VAR, when people in the booth do like to re-referee things.
Okay, finding good pockets of space. Josh Soterio trying to bend it. And it took a touch. Well, Aspro Potamitis, I think. And out for a corner. Let's have another look at it. Yeah, you're right. He's well over the sideline. Maybe VAR would have got involved.
Well, you know, they rule out offsides for a fingernail breaching the line. Anyway, it's a moot point because the ball doesn't get into the goal. McArthur breathe easy.
Curto fortunate because he got a touch on that as well. Here's the corner headed over by McGarry.
And good pressure from Newcastle. The set pieces have looked dangerous. Got some good territory. Threatening the Philip Curto goal. That's something in previous weeks that they've been able to do with any sort of regularity, threaten the opponent's goal.
Gary is only added goal, kind of gets his former club. His quickest goal so far this season. Not able to convert on that previous occasion. Soterio just on his heels there. Ferried out by Mombwa towards Craig Noon on the left. Bushcock, Miller, well, there's the numbers that underline that the Jets have made the better start of the two. Maybe that's about to change. Here's Craig Noon for slinging the cross. Off the thigh, I think, of McGarry. Mombwa with Thurgate trying to wrestle into the ground. Shows good strength. Noon delivers it across, and now McArthur had maybe struck the woodwork as well. I think Duncan got a touch. Was the frame of the goal involved as well? It was pretty close either way.
This is just beautiful from Davila. Angling that header. Look at the lean back against Newcastle.
Certainly came off the woodwork.
And he looked like someone pulling him to the green room. Off Merriweather. Mark Richards style. Beautiful from Davila.
Noon's corner. And Villa praying the neck muscles the wrong way. Well, that's got the cowbells ringing a little bit. Let's go down to Ben Homer as we watch the replay.
Thanks, Simon. Yeah, McArthur just pulling back a little bit of the momentum after, as you touched on, the Jets having a really good passage in this game. And maybe those balls in and around the box is where they're having a lot of the joy as opposed to crosses from out wide.
There's Dane Ingham. That's the goalkeepers. Continue, Ben, or had you finished?
Yeah, just Simon, last week against Sydney, the Jets were pumping a lot of crosses into the box and not getting much joy about with those. But today it just seems like when they're playing those balls in and around the box, they have had some joy hit the post. And then, of course, the chance just a few minutes ago. So maybe that's what Arthur Pappas is looking to do a little more today, focus on Mikkel Tudsey's strength.
Well, he certainly needs more service. And Arthur Pappas has tweaked his lineup today. Dacca Dartsmelia left on the bench. Runt in midfield, and Sotirio Piscopo looking to provide the bullets for the Georgian. Who we know will score if you give him the right service. There's the other Georgian. The Jets are the Georgian anyway. Becca Dantzmelia. There's Becca one. It's got to be a first in National League history, hasn't it? Harps, three Georgians involved in the same game.
I think it was a first in National League history to have one Georgian.
Yeah.
Stato Andy Howe will, I'm sure, have some demographic stat.
He'll be on it.
Based on people's heritage, but three certainly.
Jack Duncan just delayed a fraction too long there. And a few Newcastle Hearts rim mouths.
And it was good pressure from Ture. Again, for Jack Duncan in the last few weeks, he hasn't showed a real willingness to play out of the box and intersect with the game with his feet. And as that ball rolled to him, whether it was just his own instinct or it's been part of the chat, Ture really put the foot down to put the Jets keeper under pressure. He got out of it, Jack, quite comfortably in the end.
Rosos. Hey. Across to cover.
Hey.
Hasn't missed a minute so far this season for the Bulls. Tomislav Uškok. Gary. Preparing to launch the longer throw. There is a breeze that might hold it up. Yeah, you can see it just loses that flight. And then McGarry is clumsily into the back of Al Hassan Touré. Santoré, three assists this season, but just the one goal, which came against the Mariners. Operating on the right-hand side of the attack. Can play anywhere, really, across the front three. Where do you prefer to see him? Harps, out wide or through the middle? Let's just wait and see if this develops for anything for the Bulls.
Hassan Touré is an interesting one, Simon, because he's got such blinding speed that I can't get out of my mind the night he broke into the national consciousness. There's offside for Davila, good call from the assistant, which was that cup final night in Adelaide against Melbourne City, when he had, to me, one of the better centre-halves that the league's had in the last half dozen years or so, Harrison Delbridge, and he completely ripped him to shreds on halfway. which means I'd like the idea of him playing more centre, but he's a great winger if he hits his rhythm as well. He's hit Natta here, who's crumbled. This can't be a good outcome for Mark Natta.
Yeah, purely accidental, of course, but fairly poleaxed, Mark Natta. He'll pop that on the full. Of course, they've got to be careful with these sorts of injuries.
An injury assessment not required, apparently. Long, surely, before such an assessment is mandatory.
Ball's corner. Moon deep towards Aspropotamitis. Matt Miller trying to create the space to turn and shoot. Wietza still plenty forward for the Bulls. Turned back by Holman. And wide by Mombwa. Toure. Back on the left-hand side now. He and Noon interchange. Just to keep the opposition guessing. No goals, but no lack of intent from either side. Woodwork has been tested, well, I think twice. I reckon that header from Dabola actually struck the frame of the goal via a fingertip touch from Jack Duncan.
Yeah, no idea. No doubt you're right. I think the bulk of the pressurised situations have been built by Newcastle so far. Newcastle have had their share as well, and they have just got such a dynamic array of talent. Just their passing at the moment is not quite up to it.
Arthur looking to apply the press. Newcastle have got out of it, courtesy of the foul. Goal, oh so important in this game. Bulls have conceded the first goal on four occasions this season and lost all four. Newcastle, they've conceded the first goal on six occasions and lost all six. And there could be a chance for that opening goal here. Real big chance. Arapouli finds the door shut in his face by Mark Natta. And now the whistle goes.
Costa Grozos caught in possession. Arapouli adjudged to have been offside.
Natta wasn't to know that. Good defensive cover. Elsie splitting those defensive lines. Piscopo. Pirto has slid over the byline with the ball. It's going to be a Jets corner.
In a fourth for Newcastle, they've looked half likely on each of them. McArthur's defending not been completely dominant. It's opened the door for Newcastle on each of the previous three corners. Let's see if on the fourth they can make something more telling happen.
Rozos again, deeper this time with more flights. Oh, Becca Mikkeltanza went the gymnastic approach. Piscopo. Well defended by Mombwa. Toure trying to get clear, but there were just too many defenders around him. believes he was impeded. Piscopo. Timmins. Elsie. Again, they find that little pocket of space between the lines. Piscopo intelligently out towards Dane Ingham on the right. As Mikkel Tadza in attendance, and he flashes it towards goal. Well off target in the end.
Off target, and the most convincing part of it actually was the shot from Mikkel Tadza. So I'm not sure if you agree, but it was just a series of half-hearted accidental executions. Piscopo's pass was under-hit but made it to Dane Ingham, who didn't really attack the opportunity with any particular verve. Stumbled on the ball, and it was Mikkel Tadza who decided, well, we've just got to get some meat behind this attack at least. And the shot was a strong one, if wide.
This is where the Jets have been good so far, winning the ball back higher up the field. Of course, that's one thing. Doing something with it is quite another. Those Jets attacking thirds, they've largely gone down the right-hand side. Utilised Ingham on occasion. Soterio on others.
Another way to interpret that stat, nicely placed on the telly, is that that's where Thurgate's playing, as the attacking midfielder. Which is, in my opinion, where he should be playing more often than not. Not necessarily deployed on the right, but certainly further up the field for Newcastle.
Avalon is collected there. It's going to be a card. First one of the game goes to Callum Timmins. Just raked the studs down the shin there.
We'd be ready here. You just dangle a little, throw a little bone out there for the stud up, Simon, and he can't help himself.
There already,
he's,
isn't he?
He's back already.
Anyhow.
These are the only three Georgians, but further, there have been no other from the Caucasus. which was going to be your next trick question to me, wasn't it? Cheers, Andy Howe, you're a legend.
He's too good. Craig Moon surveying the scene. More elevation than that. Two footballs on the pitch. Now we're ready to go. It's a bit strong that by Miller. And Adam Kurz is going to come back to that. And Miller's going to go into the book. His fourth portion of the campaign, which puts him on the brink of a suspension. Callum Timmins going bowling over the top of it.
Yeah, Matt Miller is asking a question or protesting. I'm not quite sure what his case is. I think that was pretty clear from the ref. The only question of whom I ask is why he maybe didn't let that advantage roll out just a fraction longer. He held on, did Adam Kersley, but there was a chance for that to sweep further upfield. Nevertheless, and Matt Miller's contribution, I think the yellow card is due.
Gary's throw, and again they find space between the lines. It's Piscopo. One way out. It's rather ambitious that, but felt it was worth a try. Piscopo. Mikkel Tadza. Piscopo again. Again, it's just that final ball, Hubs.
Morena's getting a lot of ball in advanced positions and facing forward and carrying the ball forward, but he's really only found one clean outlet so far. Not entirely convinced it was as smooth as it might have been, but still, it got out to Dainingham that attack or two ago. Since then, really running into brick walls.
Touré. Bushcock. Miller. For Holman. This wasn't on that ball, was it? For Davila. It's not quite got into a rhythm as yet, the Bulls. It's a solitary opportunity, really, for Uli Davila. Should count the chance for Arabuli, which was later flagged, of course, for offside. The Jets have created a fair few. Touré. Done well to get out of that. Promptly given away by Arabuli. Thurgay turning forward and clipping it over the top intelligently, looking for the run of Sotirio, but Aspropotamitis track back. Well defended. I think Dwight York will be overly happy with what he's seen so far, particularly as the Bulls are the home side.
No, and you know, we've made the assumption, Simon, that based on last week's heavy loss to the Wanderers, that he's declared a show of faith from a starting 11, some of whom mightn't have made the cut if he was in a less kind of mood. And if that assumption is in any way accurate, it's not going to be a very pleasant half-time for the MacArthur players. They really haven't repaid the patience and the faith of the coach in this first half on balance. Newcastle have been a big part of that. They've been much more dominant in their mindset, if unconvincing, in the final execution. MacArthur just haven't been able to break free so far.
Davila is perhaps the man that can do it. No foul there. Clean win of the ball from Costa Grozos. Forward come the Jets again. Sotirio. Trick his way past Ushkot. Noon. Driven back by McGarry. He went a little bit heavy and then Ushkot just reaching for the ball. Just overstretched a fraction. For a second, there was a bit of concern over Timmins. He's just reaching for that ball.
Yeah, got it cleanly.
The studs are not showing.
It's not to say Timmins wasn't hurt by it, but it's MacArthur. It's not been comfortable for them. Very rarely have they made their possession look comfortable. The pass into an area which is even slightly contested has looked even more contestable because the pass has lacked confidence. There's another cut out there. They have to work hard to try and get it back. It's just not happening for the Bulls so far.
And they do have the worst pass completion stats in the entire competition coming into today's game. Just below 74%. The Jets are one of the best. Piscopo, slalom's clear of that challenge. The cutback looking for Piscopo, and then he looks to try and be a little bit too clever. Ball's still struggling to get the ball away. Now they should be able to. So, an inadvertent pass by Sotirio straight to Noon. They just do not look overly comfortable in possession.
The ball's not sticking at all. Control's bad. A little sluggish also. So we've got the run of them at the moment. What to do? There's Dwight York. There's two trusted lieutenants either side. Dwight York City. Does that make Anthony Clear a right tenant?
He could get fired up on occasion, Dwight York, as well. Certainly the level of the game that he's played at. Knows what standards are required. I'm not sure his team has met them, at least as yet, this afternoon. Elsie for the Jets. Put forward nicely. Michael Tadza forgot to take the ball with him. To drop into those deeper pockets, Becker Mikkel-Tata at times. Not just a goal scorer. Here he is again. Piscopo, that's going to be a free kick. And another card, this time for Charles Mombwa.
Well, approaching half time, the MacArthur situation has come about because of their own lethargy. And also because, probably to a greater degree, the pressure put on them from Newcastle. So this opportunity that Newcastle have created over the course of the half because of a more dedicated approach, a little bit sharper across the ground, they're missing some quality. I don't think that should go without saying either. But the opportunity is there for Newcastle. They shouldn't bank on it being there in the second half if Dwight York can work some magic in the sheds at half-time.
See if Becker Mikkel-Tata can perhaps work some magic from the free kick for the Jets. Drives it into the wall and then shanked horribly wide by Costa Grozos. A bit frustrating for Arthur Pappas, but his team has certainly had the better of things. Just under 3 minutes to go, Arthur. Plus stoppages, of course. The XG rate suggests that Newcastle have had the better of things. That's an awkward one for Dane Ingham. And Torres got wrong side and scores from close range. Against the run of play, MacArthur hit the front. Dane Ingham got into a terrible mess with an awkward bouncing ball, and Alhassan Touré was too strong, too powerful, and too accurate with the finish.
Well, on the Harvey Norman replay, Willie Davila just hooks the ball into the danger zone, and he's all at sea, Dane Ingham. And Alhassan Touré can use his body as a shield, which is a very difficult shield to penetrate. When he gets himself set, which he does here, and finds the back of the net. And the story continues for the Jets. In almost all games where they dominate possession, they come out losing the football match. And they've certainly had most of the ball in the first half, but they're hit with a sucker punch from Alhassan Touré here in Campbelltown.
Well, he's grabbed a couple of assists in the last three matches. Now he's on the score sheet himself. His second of the season. And I have to say, that is largely against the run of play. Can they get back on level terms? Oh, Curto came a long way and clattered into his opponent. What on earth was he thinking? A yellow card, it's deemed a football challenge, but it's clumsy. He clearly fouls Josh Soterio, and the Jets immediately go back down the other end and have a penalty. What on earth is the goalkeeper thinking there? It's a total brain fade, because Aspropotamitis probably gets there.
Well, the concession of that penalty sums up where MacArthur have been in this first half. They had a stay of execution with that goal from Alhassan Touré, and effectively from the restart, Dwight York's back where he started, almost. The penalty to follow, of course, as we saw yesterday at Allianz Stadium, the awarding of a penalty is not always guaranteed to result in a goal. But it would be the least that Newcastle deserve. If not for their own great play, but certainly because MacArthur don't really deserve to go in it. In front. A couple of minutes of stoppage time.
Yeah, that might be another one to be added onto that because Josh Soteriou is still down with a whack to the ribs. That's my interpreter. Yeah, he's caught it pretty heavily in that area, hasn't he? That hurts.
I wouldn't be surprised if they're checking the concussion as well. Calamitous from Curtis.
Any suggestion that that should have been a red, or does the presence of Aspropotamitis rule that out in terms
Yes, some rules it out in my mind. But the presence of Aspropotamitis should have met with Curtis. Stayed where he was.
Well, Soteriou's up and about. Becca Mikkel-Tatta has had a fair bit of time to think about this. Philip Curto did save a penalty against Sydney earlier on this season. Right on the stroke of the break. It's Becca Mikkel-Tatta, and he's put it well wide. Well, this is not the weekend for good penalties in the Isuzu Ute A-League men's competition. Arthur Pappas shows no emotion. Philip Curto, the most relieved man inside Campbelltown Stadium.
Well, it's a close to the first half, which is hovering around the farcical side, actually. The goal Newcastle conceded was bad, but it happens in football. The penalty conceded by Curto was ridiculous. And then Becca Mikkel-Tatta can't find the target.
Well, Arthur Pappas must be thinking he's run over a black cat or something, because by rights, Newcastle should be at least level, probably better than that. And instead, with the break not too far away, they're behind. And by and large, they've played pretty well.
Yeah, that was the point. On 41 minutes, I looked at the clock as I made it. Newcastle had, largely through their own exertions and contributed to by MacArthur's poor application, had built a foundation and they needed to take advantage of it. And here they are finding themselves a goal behind.
Another day of drama in the A-League. Alhassan Toure is the man on the score sheet. An awkward bouncing ball that Dane Ingham couldn't deal with. And then less than a minute later, Philip Curto with a total brain fade, clattering into Josh Soteriou, but Becca Mikkel-Tatta could not convert from 11 metres. And Newcastle, despite all their good work, go into half-time, trailing on the score sheet. MacArthur 1, Newcastle Jets 0 at the break.
Running with the crew, now we're winning more than dollar signs. At the corner, tapping shoulder, no extra time, energy. Waiters, haters, talking about it, kind of elderly. Dual numbers on the board, no jeopardy. Started at the bottom, now they want a referee. Got a lot of shots, give me for the center.
Thank you. This year's Alex Tobin Medal is brought to you by Isuzu Ute. It's going bigger and better than ever, with the winner of the prestigious award receiving $10,000. Plus, the Isuzu Ute Alex Tobin medalist will nominate a junior football club of choice to win a brand new top-of-the-range Isuzu D-Max or 7-seat MUX during the grand final in May. To stay in touch with the leaderboard, tune in for weekly updates at your new home of football.
Thank you.
a very difficult half-time team talk for Arthur Pappas. The Jets dominating most of the proceedings, but they could not get their reward. Becca Mikkeltadze missing from the penalty spot. Arthur Pappas still busy making notes. MacArthur have made a change at the interval. There's the goal scorer, Alhassan Toure. Akira Backus is to be introduced for the second half. There he is, in place of Charles Mombwa, who is one of three Bulls players to pick up a yellow card in the opening 45. Not sure whether that's the reason. There's a Mombwa as we get set for the second half. Jets behind in an A-League men's match for the seventh time this season. They've lost all of the previous six. And another stat of concern, Andy Harper, is the fact that they've scored just one second-half goal since the opening round of the season. That was Becca Mikkeltadze's winner in the first F3 derby in Gosford.
And, they're in a trough, results-driven trough at the moment, Newcastle. Arthur Pappas has been moving players on the chessboard, but they can't come up with the checkmate situation.
Here's a chance for them, perhaps. Lifted into the box by Timmins. Now it's Thurgate. And plucked out of the air by Curtin.
And dominating the possession in the first half. Well, they weren't terrorising MacArthur, but they certainly had control of the game. And this has happened so often from a position of dominating the ball, they find themselves behind and now have scored the one goal in the last four and a half matches. Pressure continues to build on the players, confidence drops. Start looking one teammate to another for someone to break the cycle.
No changes made as yet by Arthur Pappas. Have Becca Dartsmilia on the bench. There's Daniel Steins. So, of course, the youngster Archie Goodwin. I know a lot of Jets fans would like to see more of. They need a game breaker from somewhere. There's Archie Goodwin on the right. Back to take it off the toe of Arabuli. Sorry, Andy.
No, I was just going to say, I mean, there's a couple of unforced errors. Arabuli's yet to really get his full game legs together. He scored some goals, but not quite moving as he might, or else he would have pounced on that ball and MacArthur would have been away. But had him in his pocket without breaking sweat.
Lifted towards the left-hand side of the box by Grozos. Piscopo. McGarry trying to hit the byline. Noon not of a mind to let him. Into the box it goes now for Thurgate. With Aspro Potamitis at his back. Jets doing well to retain possession of the ball up until that moment. Responsibility on the shoulders of Renaud Piscopo, of course, this season. Expected to sort of pick up where Daniel Peña left off last season in that creative role. No easy task. It's Noon. And Alhassan Toure should have been two. And Arabuli saying, "Why don't you square it to me?"
What's an incredible chance for MacArthur.
Leading back into it, wasn't he, Alhassan Toure? Van Ingham's done well to track that one down. Gets away from Toure and then swept out by Holman.
Well, just not sharp enough, Alhassan Toure, and having scored the goal in the first half, he shouldn't really be lacking sharpness.
That's clever by Thurgate. Backus doing his job at the expense of a corner.
Big half this for Backus, Simon. Big half was huge for the club upon return to A-League men's football in their triumphant run to the cup. One has dropped off the radar in recent weeks, and his team need him back at that form in the centre of the MacArthur midfield.
Oh dear, Costa Grosos. Right underneath that one. And the Jets' fifth corner is somewhat wasted. Potomitis has turned the ball straight back over, threaded through for Thurgate. And that little deflection off Aspropotamitis favoured Curto.
Well, a remarkably sluggish start to the second half from both teams. All 20 field players in the dock at the moment. Under-hit passes, miss-hit passes.
That's a better one from Backus. Noon, just held up by Elsie. Gets it back, Craig Noon looking to bend it. Jack Duncan at its measure. Weird set, driven back by Thurgate. It's a good turn by Holman. Gabala. Back by Toure. Bushcock. And Miller. Backus. I think that was intended for Holman, but turned out all right for Arabuli. And Noon is away down the right. Cutting in, and Devola! And it bounced off the frame of the goal, onto Jack Duncan and behind for a corner. And I'm not sure the keeper knew too much about it.
It was a beautiful run from midfield. Daninger, rightly so, says, well, who's tracking the Mexican? Probably the most dangerous player in the competition on his day. It's the second time that he's hit the post with a header. And Jack Duncan very, very relieved that that rebound was kind to him and his team. Not that Jack would have been in any way culpable for that. He's appalling marking out of midfield from Newcastle.
Well, the third time in total that the woodwork has been grazed. Noon with the outswinging corner, easily dealt with at the near post by Grosos. Holman for Davila. Noon. Another corner, this time off Ingham.
Well, by my recollection, Simon, this is the first time in the match that MacArthur have been able to launch repeated raids on the Newcastle goal. Maybe a slight turning of the tide in favour of the home team as far as the flow of the game is concerned.
Noon, a bit more elevation this time. Miller threw himself at it. Volleyed with real power back towards goal by Jake Holman. Newcastle had enough bodies in the way. Noon again, crossing with the right boot this time. Miller reached it, but couldn't control it.
That's good leap from that Miller. Very, very strong individual. And did what he could. It was a tough one to control that. Got the whack in the back of the head. As it was, and on another day, this from Matt Miller could very reasonably fall into the path of Arabuli. The better from MacArthur in the last couple of minutes. Jets, by comparison, just hanging on.
Rosos. Neat turn to get himself out of trouble. Ingham. It's a poor ball by Dan Ingham. Just at the point where the Jets look well set. Timmins. 19 clearances made by the Bulls. It's a reflection, at least in part, of the Jets' play in the first 45. Quite hit their straps as yet in the second half of the game. Pappas is going to go to the bench. And we are going to see the arrival of Mohamed Altay and Becca Dartsmelia pretty shortly. And they get back on level terms before those changes are made. It's another cross that hasn't really hit the mark for the Jets.
No!
Duncan by Elsie. He's put under pressure by Toure. And now those changes will be made.
Substitution for Newcastle Jets.
Costa Brozos and Callum Timmins are the two to make way. So a combination of inspiration. At least Arthur Pappas will hope from the Georgian, Dartsmelia. And you know you're always going to get perspiration from Mohamed Altay. He will provide cover for the defensive line. See if those changes do the trick for the Jets. They could really do with the results today, as mentioned at the top of the show. Leave them still down in ninth position, heading towards halfway point of the competition.
And as you mentioned in the first half, Simon, the score remains intact and the Carthage find themselves in fourth place. Having not set the world on fire themselves, it should be said today.
Michael Tata has wriggled clear there. It's Josh Soterio. He just wanted that extra touch which allowed Jonathan Aspropotamidis to gobble up the ground. They'll get a corner. Arthur Pappas might feel it should have been more.
We saw in the first half Soterio put in front of goal and his first touch took him away, and it's similar here. Aspro was the defender on both occasions. He asks for offside. It might have been tight if he had to go to VAR. And that touch just takes him too wide. And it brings Aspropotamidis back into the equation. Corner to come, which will be interesting to see.
Dartsmelia's delivery into a decent area as well. And flicked on by McGarry. Appeals in vain for another corner.
Interesting to see, Simon, because even if that was offside in the lead-up, because he didn't score from it, it's play on. But you score from the corner, which comes from that offside play. That's where my mind was taking me.
It's the vagary of the rule, isn't it?
But if you're the Jets organisation, you're the fans who've driven down the M1 onto the M2 and the M7, you find yourself down at Campbelltown in reasonably good numbers, enjoying the sun, if not the performance of their team. But they need to take heart that, you know, this is far from an insurmountable task in front of them. And the MacArthur have hardly set the world on fire here today.
Yeah, really, the ball should have had a second. Alan Santore is on the ball here with a great chance. And teed up by Noon. Wietse into the box. Clearing header by Jordan Elsie. A reload through Backus and now Holman. Wietse with time and space. And it's a decent ball in, and Arabulli should have made it too. Are they going to be made to pay for these missed chances, MacArthur?
Well, they're lucky to do it, really, because Angus Thurgate looks at Dane Ingham, who looks back at Angus Thurgate. Who's got Ivan Bujica? Answer, no one. And he takes his time to pick out a beautiful cross. Oh, we should have made it 2-0. We saw him a couple of weeks ago at Allianz. Really lethal as a centre forward. He, at this point of his A-League career, he's not offering much between the penalty areas. But against Sydney FC on that day a couple of weeks ago, he was lethal in the box. Brilliant strike play. And he really needed to rediscover that form. You'd reckon, given the way this game has gone, 2-0 might become insurmountable. And the MacArthur striker scored that. As it is, the Jets still alive.
Right, especially as the Jets are yet to hit double figures this season, or this is going to be a card. Mohamed Altay, fresh off the bench, and almost immediately into the referee's notebook. And we did say that's the sort of grunt he provides in midfield, but he was late there on Davila. He cops a fair bit, the Mexican.
But a bit of tension from Mohamed Altay, just overstepping the mark. But if you're Arthur Pappas, you're saying, right, we want that sort of close attention on Uli Davila when he breaks from midfield into the penalty area, please. Because that's where he's hit the post twice. That's might be part of your job, Spec, to see if you can keep him on his backside on halfway. But if you're the Newcastle, your coach, you're saying, can you add to that by tracking him into our own penalty area and stopping that threat as well?
A tame free kick from Jonathan Aspropotamitis. Centurio looking to link up with Thurgate. They're going to throw Newcastle. Shoulder from Soterio as Thurgate outside it. It's good defensive block there from Holman. One back by Ingen. Mikkel Tata, or rather Soterio, I should say. Smelius lost out to Davila. Nata. Dan Smelia into the box. Good ball by the Georgian. Needed that strong left arm from Philip Curto. See, the flag was up against Soterio.
Long time between drinks for the Jets, though. A penetrating pass out of midfield in the final third. And he's clearly straight offside there. But that's merely a just piercing the line. So he did his job well. And for all their possession in advanced areas, they haven't been able to find that pass nearly enough, or a pass like it. Newcastle.
Odd that is potentially awkward for Jack Duncan to deal with off Arabuli. Yeah, not too much to worry about. Now here's that first or second change, I should say, for MacArthur, and they're going to replace the goal scorer Al-Hassan Touré with Daniel Arzani. Might have had a double today. Al-Hassan Touré, here's the one that counts. Currently still divides the teams. He gets the low fives. Daniel Arzani takes his place. A job to do. His job today, at least, is done. Has put in a couple of decent balls, one from a corner, one from open play. Drives it towards the back post. That's probably his least impressive of the three. And he's going to provide another corner from the Jets, for the Jets. Kersey not happy that Backus was 10 metres away. Piscopo's delivery, and that was acrobatic from McGarry. but unfortunately for Newcastle, inaccurate.
Well, the corners for Newcastle have been there or thereabouts for the most part. Gary making good space, but not able to control that volley.
Newcastle have to find a spark from somewhere. That's a good intervention from Ingham to keep it away from the clutches of Arzani.
He didn't look particularly ready then. He reacted a bit late, I think, Daniel Arzani. Since coming off the bench, sometimes it can take a little while to get your sea legs. He's got a lot to prove. His form at the start of the season had a lot of people talking, his own coaches, and certainly people keenly anticipating the Socceroos World Cup in Qatar.
Gary, first time ball, and Sotirio sliding in. Well, he's a touch unfortunate, perhaps. But again, Becker Dartsmelia was the architect behind that with the early release, and it was a really good centre from McGarry.
Yeah, well, fresh from his volley, McGarry. It's going to have been called back, and he gets the goal from that, but they get the corner. Another case in point that looked offside to me.
Dartsmelia's made an impact. Here's his latest corner, poured away by Curto. Brought down beautifully by Renato Piscopo. Could have got anywhere off Holman. They're relieved to see it go behind for a corner.
Very relieved, Jake Holman. He's worked incredibly hard today, Jake Holman. Has looked a little lacking in confidence in possession.
The latest corner for the Jets. Gary again trying to throw himself at it. He's been a threat from set pieces. But MacArthur come away with the ball. It's Uli Davila. Tie with him. What a reverse pass for Arzani. Good stuff this from the Bulls. Arzani's delivery and Arapouli. Well, that would have been probably the goal of the weekend had it gone in.
Yeah, well, Arzani, it's a big part of the season for him. He's got to find that early season form. As it is, he finds Arapouli on the back post. That's a really difficult effort. This just speaks to the sort of quality that Arapouli suggests for the MacArthur penalty area. They can get the ball into it. That was a really difficult execution. It came very, very close. Well done to him.
Third gate for the Jets. The space wide left, but it's gone behind Piscopo. I think the introduction of Dartsmelia has certainly changed things for the Jets. It's offered just that little bit more penetration with the passing. Elsie. He turns the ball over. Holman inviting Arzani forward. Cuts inside Elsie and goes to ground. A little bit theatrically, but there was some contact from Ingham. Free kick.
Jenkins, I'm not 100% sure, Simon, if Jordan Elsie's 100% sure. Or well, I mean, it was a hopeless give up there, really. And he gave the ball away on half. Maybe that pass. I do wonder if Jordan's okay today.
The Bulls are ready to bring on Jed Drew. We're told Craig Noon is going to be the man to be withdrawn, but he wants to take this free kick before his number's called. See if he can add a fifth assist for the season. And perhaps put the game to bed for the Bulls. Lurking with intent at the back post. It goes in that direction. It drops kindly for Altai. Dartsmelia makes the ball stick. And beyond him is Sotirio. It's a little unfortunate. It clips the heel. Dartsmelia again. They also recovered their defensive numbers. Jets will have to try and play their way through.
Hey, keep on!
It's fine margins, isn't it? There's that change. Craig afternoon has played his part. Jed Drew, the 19-year-old. About to come on, the former Sydney FC junior. His maiden Hayley Benz goal against the Mariners, a stoppage time winner, you might remember, in a five goal thriller up in Gosford. The Jets pushing here, turned back by Piscopo. Elsie Ingham shut down quickly by Arzani, but Ingham too strong. Thurgay Ingham. High. Dartsmelia. Into the final 20 minutes in Campbelltown. Scott going through the back of his opponent.
Yeah, just done. Necessarily heavy policing there for Wilscock. It's a clear foul. Oops, the Giro's not really in control. That ball's not going anywhere. Dangerous, in fact. Advise Tommy Uscock to not make the contact as the ball comes, but to read the touch and tackle if needed. Soterio then. Archie Goodwin not far from an entrance. Will give a lot of joy to the Newcastle fans watching. More importantly, you'd think it will give his team some hope of clawing this deficit back.
And the word from the touchline is Josh Soterio will be the man to be replaced. Once the ball goes dead. Meantime, Piscopo. Elsie. So again, shut down quickly by Aspropotamitis. He's had a very steady game today. Now, Arzani away. Duncan out to meet him. The foot race is on. And the goalkeeper's determination got him there.
Well, very well done to Jack Duncan, because that is his corridor of uncertainty. Leaving his penalty area to sweep clean. A counter-attack, he did it very well then.
Actually going to be a double change for the Jets. Josh Soterio takes his leave. Archie Goodwin on for just his third appearance off the bench this season. And also Daniel Steins is going to take the place of Reno Piscopo. Busy in the first half, in particular, Reno Piscopo had that one shot that came back off the post and could so easily have gone in off Philip Curto. That's just the way the luck is going for the Jets at the moment. And of course, if you are just tuning in, they missed a penalty right on the cusp of half-time. Pekka Mikkel-Tadsa putting his effort wide of the post. Gone out of play. Faces of frustration on the Jets bench. One goal scored. And four and, well, over three quarters games of football. Score, Harps, you can't win.
No, I've heard that said somewhere before. It's yet to be disproved as a theory. And the doubt just heaps upon the players. But someone has to show the leadership to break the cycle.
It's Aspropotamitis again. Backus on that touchline. Carpenter so showing good desperation, those 27 clearances. Newcastle have had good spells of pressure. Here's Arzani, has Wietzer outside him. Here is the fullback, and the deflection could so easily have deceived Jack Duncan. Good soft hand though by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, he's been comfortable today, Jack. Duncan for Newcastle. This could have been horrible for the Jets. The deflection off Dane Ingham, who made an earnest effort to recover the ground, exposed outside of him. Williamson couldn't put a cross in of any real substance, but Jack Duncan did well on the rebound.
Stein bundled over by Holman. And Kersey letting the game flow. Altai. Ingham, top of the shoulder, gets rid of Bujica with ease and slides it in for Daniel Steins. I think he almost shot on the ball there, Steins. I think he was going to try and flick it over the goalkeeper.
No, you're right, Simon. And look, I'm not sure if you were seeing the same thing, but I'm watching Philip Curto, who's on that yellow card because of that nonsense concession of the penalty, which went unpunished at the end of the first half. A confident Curto comes out and cleans that, but he was in that real doubt phase. And Steins trot on the ball. Here it is. Look at Philip Curto here. Normally it... what do I do? And he's rescued by the substitute's poor touch.
Ever-growing signs of desperation from the Jets. Trying to quicken the tempo. Steins draws the contact from Drew. Free kick for the visitors. They're eager to get on with things. Thurgay. Has to turn back out. Nato. It's a nothing ball from Nato. MacArthur can counter. Alzani. In full flow. Elsie desperately trying to get back. Still Alzani. In the end, he tried to do too much, the winger. It sort of sums up the game, doesn't it, in many ways. There's been a lot of promise in the attacks, but all too often, no end product.
Well, it's a lack of intensity in the thought process. This has been a mistake of them, really. Mark Natter's giveaway from nothing. The field opens up. Daniel Alzani just runs himself into nothing when so much more promised.
Bushcock to lift it over the top of McGarry. There's Jed Drew for company. Broken down for the Jets, his Ulysses Devila. Arabuli will leave it for Alzani. Little lift over the top, could this be it? A really important hand by Duncan, but it's in now off Ulysses Devila. And that should be enough for the 3 points for the Bulls. Finally, the second goal has arrived, and it looks like the Jets are beaten.
Well, still time, but they do look to be beaten units. That's clever from Alzani. Great run from Backus. And it's a good touch, really, to save the day on the Harvey Norman replay to start with from Jack Duncan. But they're prone defensively, the Jets, and it started with that appalling giveaway from McGarry at left fullback. And then they didn't recover the numbers. Once the ball had been given away, MacArthur just poured forward and the Jets watched them. Just watched them. And it would have been finished off earlier were it not for Jack Duncan. But you're not going to deny the magical Mexican from there. 2-0, MacArthur.
Just his second of the season. And it's a vital one for the Bulls, who probably haven't been quite at their best this afternoon. They've certainly created more chances in the second half. With a bit of invention from Daniel Alzani. Caused panic in the Jets' defence. In the final analysis halves, it's the two fullbacks who are probably culpable for the two goals for Newcastle. Ingham for the first and McGarry for the second.
I mean, it's just not going to be a very nice replay for the Jets to watch. Having said that, they've given a couple of balls away and there have been a few breakaways that MacArthur didn't maximise. Where to for Arthur Pappas?
And he'll be wondering how this one has got away from his side. Because for large parts, they've been the better side. Maybe a little bit less so in the second half. Here's Steins, still time for them. But they need to start the journey soon. And the ball's now content to play almost exclusively on the counter. Garpsmulia's ball in. Way by Ushkov. Picked up by Dane Ingham. Little threaded ball for Thurgay. Might get a second go at it.
Well, and the organisational deficiencies of Newcastle, individual errors, shouldn't really allow us to take away from the little bit of magic from Daniel Arzani. The ball over the top of that defence was really clever. The run from Backus was excellent. And really important for Kieran Backus to contribute like that, get himself back into first-team contention on a regular basis.
Karabuli looked a mile offside, and was. And into the last 10. Newcastle Jets' next engagement is away to Western United on the 15th of January. The team directly below them on the ladder, and equally desperate for points. For Western Sydney Wanderers come calling to McDonald Jones Stadium on the 22nd. As for the Bulls, they've got another New South Wales local derby of sorts against the Mariners on the 13th, and then they go to Adelaide the week after that. As things stand, Dwight York's team will be in fourth tonight. I don't think they've been at their best, but they've been good enough.
Yeah, 100% correct. It's scary that they've been so far off their best. MacArthur, by my estimation, just my opinion, and they're still too clear. They hit the post twice as well.
Here they go with Jed Drew down the right, cutting inside McGarry. Square of them is Davila, and wide left is Arzani. Tees his way past Ingham, and he's done brilliantly. Oh, Jed Drew just trying to jab the ball over the line. But again, an exciting run from Daniel Arzani.
Yeah, teasing run from Arzani. Well done from Jed Drew, but the best of them all, really, in the final analysis was Jack Duncan, who saves Newcastle again. Drew might have been a bit more emphatic with his contact there. The Newcastle keeper standing between the Jets and humiliation here in the closing stages.
There's the As Live ladder, which shows MacArthur will move up three places into fourth. Newcastle will remain in ninth. Thurgay. Steins. They're making an interesting finale. Garpsmulia. Decent try. And the Jets are going to make a change that is going to bring up an historic milestone here. Jason Hoffman to replace James McGarry, and about to make his 197th appearance for the Newcastle Jets, which means he moves past Ben Kantorovsky in terms of the all-time A-League appearance list and becomes number one outright for the club. Congratulations to him.
Yes, big congratulations to the Hoff. It's a milestone out of Hamilton Olympic and into a professional career, which has seen him down at Melbourne City, as Melbourne Heart, then back to Newcastle. And the Bullies had enough for the day, pulled up a bit sore.
Anthony Carter is going to replace the Georgian.
And with the Newcastle team, Simon, because there is time, do get out of this, they should carry Jack Duncan off on their shoulders. And this one should be gone completely from a subpar MacArthur, who without Jack Duncan in the frame of the goal, aggregate them really good chances for MacArthur, and they're four or five clear. Newcastle had some good opportunities, although they haven't created such tight chances as that. And then, of course, there was the penalty to equalise just on half time that Mikko Tadze hit wide.
Tadze's first involvement is clumsy and painful for Dane Ingham. Jets staring down the barrel of what would be their seventh defeat of the season. Altai. Now Smelia. Steins. Now Smelia. Ingham, Berge, Dantzmelia. Ball on a string there, the Georgian, and drew the foul. I think he's been pretty decent off the bench, back at Dantzmelia. Offered them that little bit of spark at times. Is like from the free kick. Bunch of players looking to make their move. And then I fancy the wind just sort of got behind that and helped it on its way. That's the midriff of Philip Curto. Vujica. Set halves of the MacArthur haven't probably been at their best, but it's been a good response in terms of their professionalism to the 4-0 hammering they took last week at the hands of the Wanderers.
Well, you know, in part that's what Dwight York was counting on, planning on, had tried to leverage and manipulate. They do secure the 3 points from here, and it's going to be a miracle for Newcastle without it.
Get through. On the same page as Backus.
It'll be the adage, how comforting it is to win when you play poorly. There's such comfort for Arthur Pappas. All those long-suffering Jets fans have got a long drive home. Quite frankly, deserve better.
Some pretty glum faces wearing those gold jerseys in the castle part of the stadium. Yellow card issued here to Anthony Carter, who has continued the conversation, and he's got to be really careful that that yellow doesn't turn into a red. And he's been told so in no uncertain terms by Adam Kersey. He's almost showboating a bit here. There he goes again. He wants to entertain the crowd, doesn't he, in these closing moments?
We're in another set of circumstances, Simon. It'll be the Bulls teasing the Matador.
Oh. through by Vujica. Davila is behind Drew. Retrieved by Backus. The turn gets him away from Steins, and it's awkward, that cross for Duncan. And he has to help it on its way and behind for a corner.
Too difficult. Is the ball just hung? Jack Duncan spots the ball away, and I just, in my estimation, he's the one Newcastle player who leaves the field with his reputation intact this afternoon, Jack Duncan.
Zani gives the signal. Best corner, in fairness. Wiskok. About to move into injury time in Campbelltown. There's going to be 4 minutes. As indicated by Anne-Marie Keithley, the fourth official. Score sheet, Harps for the Jets, remains resolutely blank.
Yeah. 11 games nearing, well, the 11th game of the season nearing its completion for Newcastle, 9 goals for.
And kept scoreless, if they don't score here, in 6 of their last 9. Developing into a real problem. Of course, they did lose at the outset of the season. Large part of last year's attack, not just Daniel Peña, but also Olivia Bumal, Valentino Yule. You could add Sammy Silvera, maybe even Sava Satravanis as well. But you think there's still goals in this squad, though? What's missing, apart from the obvious?
Well, I do think there is a... differential. Need more quality. Confidence is down. I mean, they started the season with a couple of wins. It's masked over the personnel issues, in my opinion.
Pumped forward by Jay Coleman. A very steady game, part of the Bulls' midfield. And even a goal now for the Jets, you'd fancy would just be consolation. Steins. Backus finds Carter. Tend to play a bit of keep ball, perhaps. Wiskok. Miller. Zani. Chance of United in the background from the Newcastle fans, staying faithful till the last. People forget that United is still a part of their name officially.
Feeling like Jets.
Well, they're still United, at least. And their team is on the cusp of another defeat. For a first half that was in many ways so promising. That's this penalty on the stroke of half-time. proved crucial, and they've not quite been the same in the second stanza. Bulls have created the lion's share of the opportunities. And they're on the cusp of 3 points. And maybe the Bulls a third goal here. Jordan Elsie robbed all too easily. Three against one. It's Anthony Carter. And Jack Duncan prevents further damage. Dwight York can smile about it. He knows the points are safe. But really, that should have been three.
Possession coughed up embarrassingly so for Newcastle again. Mark Natter really just had to be there. It slowed the MacArthur advance, but just not clinical enough. Jack Duncan, great work from him in the Newcastle goal again. Kudos to the gloveman, who stands on the edge of the abyss and refuses to yield. Men in blue in front of him can't say the same.
Davila and Arzani looking to entertain the crowd in these closing moments. Arzani and Drew, he's getting involved in the act as well, still alive. And Adam Kersey brings it to a close. A round of applause from Dwight York. Job done. Alan Santoro with a big smile. He got them on their way just before the break after Dainingham didn't deal with an awkward bouncing ball in the second half. It was James McGarry's error turning the ball over, which provided the chance for Ulysses Davila. Only Jack Duncan's heroics prevented more goals. Arthur Pappas' team were good in the opening 45. But that missed penalty from Becca Mikkeltadze proved crucial as he sent his effort wide. And the Bulls in the end, comfortable for the win. They charge back up the ladder into the top six as they return to form and condemn the Jets to a seventh loss in 11 games this season. Pressure building in Newcastle, pressure relieved for Dwight York and the Bulls in Campbelltown. Full-time scoreline in the southwest of Sydney. MacArthur Bulls 2, Newcastle Jets 0. Let's go down to Ben Homer.
Thanks, Simon. Yeah, I'm here with Jonathan Aspropotamides. Jonathan, fifth clean sheet of the season for you and the Bulls. That's equal season's best across the league. What does that mean to you guys?
Yeah, it means a lot. I think from a defender's point of view, it means everything. We pride ourselves on defending. Last week we slipped up a little bit. We copped a few goals that we weren't proud of, and we had a look at ourselves during the week, and we knew that wasn't us. So we rectified that, and so happy to keep a clean sheet. Got a bit lucky there in the first half. We rode our luck. We know that. Copped a roller king from the boss at halftime, so we knew about that for sure. But yeah, it was a great win for the club and up into the top four, which is good.
So what did Dwight York say at the halftime interval to get you guys a little bit more up and about after maybe a first half where you didn't deserve the lead, but you had it?
Yeah, I think there's been a few games like that this season. We probably didn't deserve things, but we've stuck out. We've defended well. Okay, yeah, rode our luck a little bit, but we've taken a chance when we've had it. Yeah, there was a few expletives there at halftime, as you can imagine. But, you know, we got a reaction out of us, which is great. And the second half, we played much better. Probably could have got a couple more. Had one at the end there with Carter. But, we'll take those 3 points. And good to get back on a winning run. Hopefully now we can keep a bit of consistency, because everyone in the league seems to be up and down at the moment.
Just tell me, what's working so well with you and Tommy in that centre-back combination?
Yeah, I've known Tommy for a long time. I played with him at Western United, and he came up through the MPL with Sydney United. Had a brief time in the A-League before, but he always knew he could play in the A-League, and he's showing that. Now he's shown that for the last three seasons, really, that he's up to this level. One of the best centre-backs in the league. So it's good to play with him. We have a good connection. We're good mates off the pitch. Always having coffee, so that helps as well. A few debriefs over a coffee. Which is nice, but yeah, no, he's a great player. I love playing with him, and to be fair, look, everyone in that back four and Phil as well, been so solid this season, and yeah, we're just hoping to continue that for the rest of the year.
Jonathan, thanks so much for your time post-match.
Thank you, mate. Cheers.
Jonathan Aspro there, well done to him. 3 points today, and now we'll bring in Reno Piscopo.